ticket. Here's my passport. The airport is closed. So how am I going to catch my plane? Listen, I'm sure you're fed up of explaining why no one's allowed into the airport, but I happen not to know. I bought this ticket a week ago. No one warned me.
When the airport has been cleared of explosive devices, you'll be able to enter.
Well, not quite by then. I still don't know what's going on. Bottom alert to the airport. And when will you...
Of course. There's a bomb alert in the airport.
Why? I mean, someone must have been arriving or about to leave. Someone they would as a politician or a scientist.
Already blown up.
Yeah, it's blown up.
What? Well, where's the smoke, the splinters, ruins, where are they?
It's all inside.
Inside?
Inside people. In all of us. Those people. Down in the corner. They've been torn away from something. From their own lives, made to worry, panic. Those out there on the runway. They're risking their lives opening those bags. There are three locations, and in each one of them there could be an explosive. In every one of them. But it's not ruled out. Will there be such a blast that even in here we'd be covered in splinters?
You've clearly been here for quite a while. You must be absolutely furious. And you've obviously got to the point where you know what the other's going to say, because you really seem to have your story straight.
Straight? Straight.
From this place to another. Meetings. I've packed my bag, saw me off, and she'll be waiting for me tomorrow. They'll be waiting for me there in 3 hours' time. Looks like I'm not going to be there in 3 hours.
You won't. No, you won't.
So it looks like I'm going to be late there to see how it is. What shall I do?
What indeed? What if everything blows up? Then we won't be flying anywhere for a while. Well, not until they mend everything. We won't be going anywhere at all if that happens. Well, if they remove the bomb, so we won't be going anywhere for a while. Well, they'll have to redo the timetable. I mean, it'll take them 2 to 3 hours after they put everything back.
As long as nothing blows up. I've got to get there, whatever it takes. I've got to get there.
You'll get there in about 6 hours if they defuse the bomb right now.
This is mad. What sort of age do we live in? I don't feel safe anywhere now. Only at home.
At home?
Only at home now.
You hold on. I mean, who knows what this will come to? Have you any idea what's become of competition?
Competition? What do you mean, market?
To show to someone that he's better than he really is. That's a harmless enough idea. And what's become of it?
What? What happened?
Competition is all about choice now. If there's something else on offer, why not go for it? It means choosing. It means horror of horrors, refusing. In theory, yeah. I mean, like Pepsi and Coca-Cola are owned by the same company. And this whole choice thing is just a clever trick, because if you don't buy one, you definitely buy the other. And the owner gets profit from the lot, because it's all his. All of them. Yes. Yes. So this issue's wait. It's just a decoy, it's a sham. Everything has already been decided, even now.
Now?
Yeah, you see. I'm boiling with rage inside. I can barely hold back from attacking someone because and I'm not going to get to where I want to on time. And in fact, I could have died. It's a good job they found those bags on the runway in time. And all I do is get here and wait until all this madness is over. I'm forced to take part in it all.
I'm going home. And when everything's returned to normal, I shall come back and get my flight. But right now, I'm going home because I have no desire. concern me. And actually, I don't care what happens. I'll wait it out at home. I'll change my ticket, the airline will pay the compensation, and I'll make it to where I want to go anyway. I'll make it. And actually, it doesn't matter if I'm not on time because I've got a good excuse. They can turn on their TVs and they'll see I've got a good excuse. I'll wait it out at home.
You're just trying to convince me, Sal. Do you think it will help?
I'll be back in an hour, maximum. Right, that's it. Off.
So are you really going home?
Well, yes. There's no point in hanging around here, this pantomime. It'll go on for ages.
Ages.
Goodbye.
Okay.
See you soon.
As soon as all this madness is over, there'll probably be something on the lines of stuffing us all into one plane, which will race around at the speed of sound, dropping us all off the evening.
I don't get your stupid jokes. What do you mean by that? What's the point in joking right now?
Is there anyone waiting for you there?
Who?
There. Is there anyone waiting for you? If there isn't, you might as well stay here.
It'll be a surprise.
See you then.
Up with you out of habit, and I suppose these hysterical habits. Well, did you put this show on?
For you. We'll pass in a minute. How was it for you? You find another word, anything else. You're trying to kill me.
hasn't helped me ever since school, that has. I say it in my head or out loud and time flies past and I don't think about the years that's troubling me. I just think about the years of corn and nothing else. It gets better as it goes. There's like this peasant that's meant to have ploughed or harvested the land or something, right? And then he hasn't turned up. Right? His voice comes from nowhere, right? And says to the ears of corn, he does not reap or sow the field because he is so very sick. The hands that take the strip of land have dried to old stick and the head. something not mine. But I don't like that sort of stuff. I can't get into it. Because if every part would be part of my body, and sometimes, right, my mind terrorizes another part of my body. Like right now, my mind is making fun of everything that should be turning me on. So I'm rubbing myself on New Year. I'm not getting excitement from it because that's my memory keeping me going. And even though I'm hard and I'll probably come in a minute, all that's my memory keeping me going. But eventually, it'll come to the point where suddenly I don't like the smell of someone's underwear or slops. And then the next thing is, I'll become impotent. And then that'll be it. That's it. That's it.